Hello everyone, this is Rishabh Singh. I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company. Today, the topic of discussion is men and domestic violence. Gender roles and expectations in Indian society have changed significantly since independence, and it still continues to change. The days are gone when men used to be the sole breadwinners and women were confined to the four walls of the house. The rate of crimes against women has shown a considerable decline, but still there's a long way to go before we achieve the ideal society. The progress so far has been commendable. The Protection of Women Against Domestic Violence Act 2005 was a very significant milestone in the path that has gone long way in fighting against the bane of domestic violence in past decade and a half. One of the most important features of this act is its scope. Drifting from the earlier notions, it defines domestic violence not only in terms of husband-wife relationship, but any woman in a domestic relationship with the person she is bringing the charges against, including blood relations, in-laws relations by adopting, and even live-in relationships and legally invalid marriages. So the act also widens up the scope of what constitutes violence, including not only physical violence but also verbal as well as sexual, economic and emotional abuse. With that being said, some have criticized the law, stating that it doesn't take into consideration domestic violence faced by men in the country, which there presently are no laws against. Most people, upon hearing the domestic violence against men, either see it as a trivial matter or worse, completely deny the existence thereof. In situations like this, some statistics might be of help. A 2019 study published in the Indian Journal of Community Medicine aimed at studying violence against men in rural Haryana, and the following were the results. In the present study, 52.4% of men experienced gender-based violence. Out of 1,000 males, 51.5% experienced violence at hands of their wives or intimate partner at least once in their life. Time and 10.5% in the last 12 months. The most common spousal violence was emotional, 51.6%, followed by the physical violence, 6%. Only in 1/10 cases, physical assaults were severe. In almost half of the cases, husband initiated physical and emotional violence. Gender symmetry doesn't exist in India for physical violence. Less family income, education up to middle class, nuclear family setup, and perpetrator under the influence of alcohol were identified at risk factors. Earning spouse with education up to graduation is the risk factor for physical violence. These numbers put the gravity of the situation into perspective. Domestic violence against men is not rare, but it's a reality that we live in. There may be a lot of reasons why the victims in these cases do not come forward to complain, and mostly overlap with the reasons women have, such as worrying about the family reputations, desire to keep the family united. However, one major factor particular to men, usually viewed as strong and not in need of protection, many male feel embarrassed in admitting that they have faced domestic violence. They find it better to suffer in silence. There's no denying that women face more atrocities in societies compared to men, but that doesn't mean that the needs and suffering of men should be or even can be ignored. An ideal solution thus will be a law with provisions to protect everyone against violation, regardless of their gender. So this is all about the topic. Thank you so much.